Well, today again, welcome to Form Follows Function. And if you are new on the channel and not subscribed, then do it, guys. Surely you will like the content if you are in the field of architecture. I always try to come with short videos to understand the important things in limited time. Today, I am taking another important topic which I see many of you guys want to know. So let's do it in my way and see what are the 5 things I keep in mind before I start rendering a plan, and it helps me a lot and saves my lot of time. So how I start, the first work I do is remove all the hatch. So first I make a copy of the plan and I see I have a hatch in the walls. So I hide this layer from the plan, also the hatch of the almira. And I also don't want the dimension, so I hide that layer too. This is the first and basic step. Continue watch the video. Now we are moving to the next level. Take the lines before importing. You can see in the plan, some layers have less thickness and some having more, but we want the same and bigger so that our plan can be visible in Photoshop. Let's say this. First create the new layer with the name Photoshop plan and change its line weight to 0.40 mm. Now select the whole plan and put it into this layer. You can see everything is of this line weight. If something not changed, do it manually. Now you have a question that why I do this? Because when you import PDF into Photoshop with less line weight, it will not visible properly. Let me show you this. I created the PDF with normal plan or with the plan having higher line weight. Let's import both of them into the Photoshop. So here, first I open the PDF which having higher line weight, and then I open the lower line weight PDF. It's having transparent background, so it is not visible. Let's add the white solid color layer. Now you can see this is the lower line weight plan, and see in the higher line weight plan it is clearly visible. Hope now you got why I do this. Here the third thing is get the plan and text in different layers. Why I am doing this I will show you. First I am saving the two PDF, one without the text and the other PDF with text. Then open both the PDF in the Photoshop one by one. Here first I open the PDF without the text and add the solid color layer. Then I open the PDF which having the text in the plan. Now I send this text layer to the plan which don't have the text. Then you can see now we have two layers, one which have the text and the other which do not have text. Let's name them and see what is the benefit of doing this. See, when I fill the floor color on the plan which do not have the text, it fills perfectly. But now do the same thing with the layer which having text. Fill by doing the selection. Have you noticed, guys? Here the fill is not perfect. Here we can see the spaces in between the text which is not right. So always take the text and the plain layer differently. And when you fill your plan with materials, then turn on the text layer and put it above. Okay, so move on to fourth thing. See, whenever I make the PDF, I also change the plot style table to monochrome. I export the two PDF, one with monochrome and the other with default style. And when I import both of them in Photoshop, I see that monochrome is best, as in the default style I got the colored layers which not looks perfect. So always export in monochrome. Now we move on to the fifth thing, which is too important. Always export the PDF on the same scale so that if you want the changes in your plan later, you can do it. Let me show you. First I am creating the three PDFs, where one PDF of plan which do not have the text, and I created the PDF of plan with the text with the same scale. It is important. Then I created the third PDF where I change the scale of this PDF and export these all. Now I open the PDF in Photoshop. Here you will understand what's the problem you will get if you don't print on the same scale. See, first I open the plan which do not have the text, then I open the third PDF which have the different scale. Now I duplicate this plan into the first PDF. Can you see the walls are not on the walls? As you know, the scale has changed. See, now I open the second PDF which have the same scale and then duplicate this one. So here it is. You get the perfect text as you needed. So this is my final tip which you should follow. I hope you guys love it and learn something. Do the comment below if you have any query, or if you like this video, hit the like button, or you can do one appreciation comment too. That will seriously motivate me to come with more better content. And don't forget to subscribe me. Also join me on Instagram. And thanks for 7500 plus follows on Instagram. Love you guys. See you in the next video.